Hey everyone, Mac and Jenny here. We are back with another episode detailing our 3,000-mile trip to Southeast Alaska aboard our 1980 Allberg 37 sailboat Maya. In the previous videos, we started from Anacortes, Washington, traveling 1,300 miles over 51 days through British Columbia and Southeast Alaska to where we are now in Sitka. In this episode, you'll see us meet up with family for an epic fishing and wilderness experience aboard Maya. And later in the episode, we finally tackle the project of replacing our compromised forestay. All that and more coming up. So jumping back into the story, like I said, we are in Sitka and family has just arrived.
Okay, our guests have arrived.
My dad and brother are here.
Hey! How are ya?
Camera battery died. Sorry about that. Meet Chris, Jenny's dad, and Andrew, Jenny's brother. After a quick hello, we jumped aboard and got underway, traveling 30 miles north to Kalenan Bay, which would serve as our home base for fishing Salisbury Sound.
All right, I got my dad aboard, brothers down below. We are headed out to Salisbury Sound. We're going to do some fishing out there.
Looking forward to it. It's going to be a hoot and a half.
Cool hall, quarter a ball, pick your stick hanging on the wall. Aim slow, shoot it low. Fall for it all when you never know. There's a blind date, won't roll straight.
We got a live one here.
Dang, look at that! There's a freaking fish on there!
It's not even a fighter.
Good fish!
What will he be bringing home to you? On the winds that sing of whiskey, wine, and gambling. He was green no sooner than he flew.
The next day, we sent Chris and Andrew to the airport with 20 pounds of ling cod,
halibut, salmon, and rockfish.
Bye. Okay, so we just said goodbye to my brother and my dad. We had a great 5 days of fishing, but now it's time to tackle our forestay project.
Now, if you recall, 2 days before we launched from Anacortes, we discovered our forestay was twisted and kinked at the top, which eliminated our ability to safely sail.
Yeah, so we've got some, show you our setup here. What do we got over here?
We've got two running rigging brought down forward, so that'll keep the mast up. When this thing is down, because we're taking this whole thing down.
And then also we'll loosen the backstay before we start attempting to undo the forestay. We'll see how this goes.
So first we loosened the backstay, then proceeded to take down the sail.
Okay, so we got the front forestay bottom
taken care of. That's off. So that was a little bit of a struggle. But we got that off now. Jenny's gonna go up there and we're gonna lower this whole unit down. All right, now that we've got the roller furler and forestay completely disconnected, we're gonna lower it with the halyard.
The actual furler unit was pretty heavy, so using the winch allowed it to be lowered in a very controlled fashion.
Okay, so we've got the roller furler down now, and
here's a little closer look at the top. All bent up. And
yeah, it's starting to get more rusty too.
We're gonna cut this here, pull this end down through there with an electrician's tape, and then put the new one back in and install the new Hi-Mod.
That's the plan. You know, we've never done this before and it's all a little intimidating, but we watched a YouTube video, so, you know, should be all
right. Okay, top piece is off. Now Mac is trying to expose the core.
All right, so we've got the old rigging out of the furler and we've got that right next to the new. This is the new line, and so now we're just lining these up, and we want the inner
core
wire to be cut exactly at that point.
Okay, so we were able to put the new rigging through, slide it through using the electrical snake, and now we've got our mark that we made before we did all that, and now I'm going to cut right on that line. And then we're gonna install a fitting, and that should be pretty much it.
The $1,000 cut right here.
Don't remind me of that. That's too much pressure.
So we've got the piece cut, and we've installed the little cone. And then basically what you do is you put this little piece in there.
You wanna make sure that each one of these wire strands is in its place.
Now we're gonna put in this piece here with some Loctite, and we're gonna hoist this thing back up,
and then we're gonna have a beer because this has been a not fun job.
Mac loves rigging.
I'm not a rigger.
He's an electrical guy.
Okay, that's hand tight.
Yep, it says hand tight plus 1/2 turn.
So now with the Hi-Mod installed, we hoisted the whole unit up, followed by one more trip aloft to pin it in place.
Okay, it's like past 10 p.m. here in Sitka, Alaska in June. You can see we still have daylight. Yeah, we are finally putting the finishing touches on this forestay. You can see the last thing was to put the sail back on. So we just put that back on, winched it up, the jib halyard, and now we're just about to roll it up.
It's been a really long one, but we're finally there. Perfect day to do this, I mean, really.
God, that one's been weighing on us for quite some time on this trip, so really glad to have this done and yeah, get out there back on the water.
Okay, so with our rig back in working order, that's a good place to stop. Join us next episode as we sail down Bear Enough Island's wild and remote west side, where we encounter more epic landscapes and close encounters with wildlife. All that and a whole lot more adventure coming up. And lastly, a reminder, we have an online store at cruisingmaya.com. We have special edition Southeast Alaska t-shirts and hoodies available, along with Cruising Maya hats with our logo on the front and even a little disco face on the back. Those items and a whole lot more available for purchase in our store. If you want to support us and the making of these videos, shopping in our store is the best way to do that. A special thank you to everyone who's made purchases so far. We absolutely feel and appreciate your support. Okay, with that, we're done here. As always, thank you so much for watching, and we hope to see you here next time. Cheers.
Okay, so what does $20 at Cabela's get you?
Worked good the first half the day.
2 hours?
Got a little too sporty.